Welcome to the third part of our tutorial about drum arrangements. In this episode, I will show you how to create pickup fill-ins and a proper ending for all instruments in Hookpad. In the last two videos, we've already discussed the basics and how to make sure the fill-ins are at the right place. If you've missed them, I would recommend watching them first. To start, I have already loaded the project of the last video into my Hookpad. If you are watching this video on our website, you can find a link to the song to follow along beneath. Now let's have a look at that pickup bar at the start of our song. The song indeed starts at bar 2, but our drummer doesn't know it yet and starts playing at bar 1. To change that, we need to do 3 short steps. First, we create a band marker at bar 2 to indicate the start of a new song part. Next, we have to select the first band marker as we want to get rid of the drums in the first bar. And then we can simply mute the drums. Instead of muting the drums for the first bar, we can also create a pickup fill-in. In order to do this, we scroll down to the bottom where we can find a folder called Pickups. There we have the option to choose either a simple short pickup fill-in or a more complex one. Now let me show you an even easier way to start your song with a pickup. First, we press Set to undo the last few steps. Next, we select one or more bars to bring up the other interface again and turn on the pickup measure. By doing so, Hookpad just created an extra pickup bar which automatically arranges the drums to play a pickup at the first bar. All what is left to do is to get rid of the empty measure. But before we delete it, we should move the melody pickup to the first bar. To delete a measure, we select it and then click on Remove Measure. The good thing about pickup measures is that they force your project to count the bars from 0 instead of 1. So now our second song part starts at bar 9 again. This allows us to delete this band marker. We simply select it and press the backspace key. And our fill-in is still at the right place. Now we have polished the start of our song, let's also turn our focus to its end. Right now, our drummer just keeps playing until there are no more empty bars left. To change this, we need to select a break rhythm. But of course, we have to create a new band marker first. Now in each drum folder, you can find a patch with the word break at the end. For each different style, there are one or more break patches, which fit perfectly to the other patches in the same folder. As we used a pop drum patch throughout the whole song, we should also use a pop break at the end. To form a strong final chord, we have to make sure the other instruments stop playing their rhythms as well. But before we can make any changes, of course we have to select our band marker 2 again. For the strummed acoustic guitar, there is also a break patch, which works just like the drum breaks. For the bass and the piano, we have to use a different approach, as there are no break patches for those two instruments. To simulate the final chord, we simply use patches which play long notes by default. So instead of the pop rhythm bass, we select a patch called pop bass. And for the piano, we use the piano patch. As our gospel singers and our violin section are already playing long notes by default, we don't need to change those two patches. And there we have it, our perfect final chord. Before we finish this video series, let's take a short break to summarize everything we have learned so far. The easiest way to create a pickup at the start of your song is to create a pickup measure. You can also manually create pickup drum rhythms, which allow you to start your drums later in the song. To get a proper final chord, create a band marker and select one of the break patches for each instrument. If you can't find a break patch, use a long note patch instead. I hope now you are ready to make better drum arrangements. To go deeper into the topic, I recommend studying our demo songs. If you like this video series, please give us some feedback and subscribe to our channel to get notified every time we release another fantastic tutorial. I'm Dennis, and I will see you soon.